the Nigerian 8th National Assembly is inaugurated, one senator will make the difference is Engineer Senator Mustafa Buka, senator representing Katsina North Central. We speak with him on issues concerning Nigeria's growth and development and his first constituency, engineering. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Hello, very good day to you. Thanks for joining us. My name is Kenneth Odushola Stevenson. This is Inside Business Africa, business news and information leader. Very shortly, we will come and join by Engineer Buka, who will be taking his seat at the National Assembly, especially the Senate, representing North Central. This particular senator will be expected to make the necessary difference, especially background from the executives where he served for so many years and retired in 2009, actually joined and do community work. We'll talk with him when we come back right after this commercial break. Stay with Inside Business. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Inside Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Indeed, it seems to be running against time for today because we have quite a number of content we'd like to serve you today, but time will be on our side. We'll try to make it as much as possible in general. But for now, let me bring in a very important personality. He's an engineer and also a senator representing Katsina North Central Senatorial District, especially and that's hometown of the president, Muhammadu Buhari. And let me use this opportunity to welcome Engineer Mustafa to Inside Business Africa. Senator Engineer Mustafa Buka, thank you again for joining us on today's edition of Inside Business Africa. We are quite delighted that we're able to share some time with us. But now, congratulations on winning your election and then also becoming one of the major voice that we'll be hearing at the National Assembly.
Thank you very much.
Now, my first question, Senator Mustafa Buka, you will be quite very straight. What will be your vision? You're coming to this Senate and you're winning the election did not come to us as a surprise, especially from some of us who have known you for so many years. Now, we'll be asking you, what will be your vision in coming to the National Assembly and what will be the driver of this vision?
Well, yes, we have served the country at various levels. And my vision is to see a united Federal Republic of Nigeria that has elected its own leaders who will move Nigeria forward and bring the change we need to make Nigeria great. We have had maybe big men, but not leaders. I hope we'll be able to have leaders this time that we have elected so that they can change or bring the change that APC has actually been talking about.
Well, I'm going to be talking so much about the water and water resources sector today with you, most importantly, because within the 1992 and 2001, your activities within the water sector was quite pronounced, especially where we had so much activities going on and a lot of achievement were recorded in the water sector. There were so many reforms that were part of and so many opportunities were created as indeed. Now, let me ask, you know, the sector today seems to be very depressed, so to speak. Now, what do you think is responsible for these low activities in the water sector? How do we move away from these particular norms?
So I think what we need to do is to have that water resources bill passed, even if it has been passed, to look at it. Why is it that the institutions are not functioning? And why is it that the Ministry of Water Resources has not received the political will it had before? Because when we were there, we received a lot of attention from both the state and the federal government. And we were handling quite a number of federal and state government projects with a lot of coordination. I think that coordination is lacking. And as I said earlier on, when you look at the river basins.
You're in the Senate. There will be so many reforms. How will you make an impact in this sector, especially now that you're in the Senate, and support the water sector reform that has been dangling around for many years and make the necessary impact in terms of water resources development and management in Nigeria?
But of course, we'll be able to give advice, especially in the area of legislations and, of course, memos and bills that we can make to get the ministry or the sector moved forward. And of course, we'll collaborate with whoever is in the Ministry of Water Resources, the minister and the staff there. That we are willing and we will do that.
Now, you are so in the sector and so many of these areas. Now, with you at the helm, where laws are going to be made, are you going to do anything different? And how do you describe what is currently going on in those ministries and what can be done to change the status quo?
If you look, what is the transportation policy of Nigeria? Now, when you say transportation, we are talking about intermodal transportation. That means you have to connect rail, water, air, road. It's transportation. If you look at them in a holistic view, then you'll be able to develop a policy, develop a framework within which, and a strategy within which you would like to get whatever it is you have in terms of vision or master plan as a country. We don't have that. Such responsibility at the Department of Research, Planning and Statistics, where I was a director in quite a number of ministries, like we said. But people are posted to this department because it's kind of a dry land. Because the elements or the tools that you need to function to do the research, the planning, and the statistics are not there. In fact, you don't even have the manpower that is required to do all these things. So how do you do your, how do you make your, and any place that you have no plans, you are surely going to.
Now, how do we make this river basin autonomous function?
You see, the river basins have a very big role to play in water resources management and irrigated agriculture. I think they have no business in drilling boreholes. We reduce them to drilling boreholes and therefore they abandoned what they were established. You remember under the TCPC, the river basins were commercialized. Most of what they did were actually sold off at ridiculous prices. That is history. But I think we need to bring them back if we really want to succeed in our agricultural project, development.
Then the Department of Fisheries was also to be able to rely on the river basins to actually be able to develop the fishery. Now, do you think we should continue with this kind of trend and they follow this particular part where the river basins can also support the fishing industry?
Yes, you see, as we said, the water is supposed to be allocated for various uses. And recently you can see, in fact, over the years, that fishery farming, actually fish farming, has very much increased in the country. And it's another source of protein, and also that's very lucrative. I don't see any reason why water cannot be allocated for fishing. So we have a lot of economic activity that we can create to reduce poverty using the water that we have stored in various locations. So I believe that river basins could be done, I mean, could be used to provide water for fishing.
Well, I'm going to be talking, asking you some things about this particular, you know, trend that's actually taking root in Nigeria now, the sachet water business. Really, are we really doing it well? Do we really need sachet water if all the other sectors, the components of the water resources is working very well? And what are the danger in actually doing these kind of things around Nigeria?
People have been taking water of various qualities, but the most interesting thing is that even the so-called pure water is not pure. You see, it's not pure because, and even the bottle is dangerous, because what people don't understand, if you go anywhere, you find pure water under the scorching sand. It's left under the sand for a long time. And that, you know, affects the quality of the water, because the polyethylene bag that that is being used contaminates the water.
In simple terms, my question, but not your explanation this time. In simple terms, how do we develop water resources in Nigeria sustainably?
Government can provide a social, that's why I say water has to be looked at as a social and an economic good. A social because the responsibility of government is to give the basic service. There is a basic amount of water a human being needs in a day. That government can provide. If it goes beyond that, if you have a swimming pool or you want to wash your car, it means you are ready to buy more water. So you should pay more for water.
Well, now you are a legislator in the current administration, and you are in the 8th Assembly, and you are being inaugurated. Now, the fact of the matter is that the ministry where you functioned before, how will you describe the activities now? What are the reforms that possibly has been put on the shelf that needs to be looked at, especially coming from someone who was part of the sector reforms, and what are the things that you believe can be done to make this ministry functional?
So I think what we need to do now is to look at the ministry and its parastatals and see their performance vis-a-vis the targets given to them, or at least what the legislations that they have say they should do. Are they doing them? If not, then we have to look at the legislations, we have to look at the institutions.
In other words, the whole nation is now your constituency. How do you approach your legislative duties considering your constituency, Nigeria, and the people?
Like you said rightly, first and foremost, we now form the upper echelon of the National Assembly. Those elected to be in any assembly, be it federal or national or state, we are elected by the people because we have a function to perform, which is different from the executive. We are supposed to check what the executive does. So when you come to the National Assembly, of course, the number has reduced. That means we are representing 170 million Nigerians. So first and foremost, we have to make sure that the country called Nigeria functions the way it's supposed to function. It gets the right policies and it gets the right environment for it to become the great Nigeria that we are, not the dwarf that we have tried to be all these years. So, of course, the first and foremost thing is that we are the Senate, and I do hope to see a Senate that functions with all integrity, due diligence, and straightforwardness that is required to make sure that the incumbent, or the new government, which is the government of General Muhammadu Buhari, fulfills its obligations.
Now, how should Nigeria approach the issue of infrastructure development to ensure maximum benefit for the investment?
Thank you. Yes, we have a deficit because we have not created the right environment to have infrastructure provided. We talked about the transportation, the interlink between all those. So to start with, you need to know what you want and where you want to go. If, for instance, Nigeria wants to build highways, then you have to look at what do we need, where do we find the economic routes? What is the master plan that Nigeria has? For instance, we have seen this in India. India is a country, they have a ring road that's actually covered the country everywhere. You have 6 lanes in some sections, 8 lanes and 12 in some sections. But they have a ring, and from there you can take off from wherever you want to do. That is where it started. They have a policy. They have a plan of what they want to do. Then they have a tolling policy. What is the price mechanism that people have at the toll gates? Then from there you can begin to ask, where do we want to have greenfield projects? For instance, if Nigeria has that kind of master plan, I'd say you want to build a road from Lagos to Abuja. But greenfield, somebody will come and say, yes, I'll build it for you. Okay, fine. Send me the proposal. That is why you have the PPP arrangement that can work for new projects. Not somebody coming to take an existing road that was built by government and to take over and then, take a revenue that is not quantifiable.
Now, what is your life's philosophy and what really drives you as a person?
What drives me actually is the passion to make a difference in whatever I do. And perhaps this comes up or came to be my philosophy, because anybody who grows up in a traditional institution, we always like to make the lives of other people better.
Well, Engineer Mustapha Buka, I want to thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us today. It's been quite a long, long interview indeed, and we hope we'll be able to accommodate some more of these, your thoughts, next week on Inside Business Africa when we bring you here on the program. And again, we want to thank you and congratulate you as you have been inaugurated as Senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, believing you will make your the best difference possible and see Nigerians smile again, especially in the water sector and infrastructure. Thank you very much again, sir.
Thank you very much.
Well, I've been speaking with Engineer Mustapha Buka. When we come back right after this commercial break, we'll talk about it. Well, that's about all we have time for on Inside Business Africa for today. I want to thank you again for joining us on this exciting journey into the world of business, finance, and the economy. Let me also say a very big thank you to Engineer Mustapha Buka, who joined us to talk about Nigerian issues and many others. And we'll be monitoring his activities at the National Assembly, especially from the Construction and Engineering Digest magazine's platform. We are very much interested in what is going on in the built environment. And every member of the community, the built environment community in the National National Assembly, watch out for what we'll be talking about, especially on BETV, a new television station being put together by Inside Business Africa and Century 21 Systems Limited. And don't forget also, June 18, Engineer Larry Sagaya will be conferred as the Professional Man of the Year 2015, and it will be holding in Lagos. And you can see some of the clips on the Inside Business as he was scrolling on. So write down the information and join us on that day to talk about engineering and economic prosperity. It's been Kenneth Odusola Stevenson presenting Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for watching. See you next week.